What's up, Sim here. I've tested quite a few lazy grippers before, but this time I'm bringing you something I've been waiting for. I bet many DIY makers have too. Cameo DYS CNC from MaxMake. Yes, this machine allows you to do CNC cutting right on your desktop. Check out some of the projects I made with it, especially this metal fidget spinner. How cool is that? Normally, making something this thick out of metal would be impossible with a desktop lazy engraver, and it would cost you a fortune. But with the DYS, you can do it for just a fraction of that. And yes, besides the CNC module, it also comes with a 10 watts blue laser head, so you can still engrave or cut with it. In this video, I'm going to focus on the CNC part. We'll go through every detail, the good and the bad. And most importantly, is it worth buying? Let's find out. Here's everything included in the box. I won't go through every piece in detail, but compared to typical laser machines, CNC definitely takes the accessory game to another level. Now, let's get onto the DYS CNC machine itself. The whole machine measures 452x425x350mm and weighs around 19 kilograms. Quite a compact compared to those bulky industrial routers we've seen before. It's got a protective shield at the front to prevent dust from flying around during operation, which is necessary since this is a powerful CNC cutter. For filming purposes, I kept the shield open so you can see the process more clearly. There's also an indicator light on the top right corner showing you the machine's working status. Open the shield and you'll see the 250 watt CNC head. There's a handle here. When changing bits, just lower the handle, insert the bit, and release. It clamps tightly and securely. We've got a work table here with the wooden spoil board featuring multiple threaded holes for fixing materials firmly in place. On the back, you'll find all the different ports and the connections. We'll get to those in a moment. That's the overall design of the device. I'm genuinely impressed by how compact, sturdy, and safe it is compared to traditional open CNC routers. But how's the performance? Let's dive right in. Let's take this wood cut as an example. First, fix the wood on the base and install the bit. I used a single edge spiral end mill for the first step, mainly for rough machining. Then we go to the software, MaxMake Live, which is developed by MaxMake themselves. I wanted to show you the full process since this is new software to many of you. Fortunately, it's actually quite easy to use, even for beginners. You'll see my results later. For example, generating CNC files should be handled directly inside MaxMake Live. They've already reserved multiple processing modes, but they're currently unavailable. So for now, you'll need to use CAD, CM software like Fusion 360 to generate your GCAD files. Once you've got your GCAD ready, import it into MaxMake Live. Adjust the bit to the material to confirm the position, and then set XY0 and Z0 in the software. That's basically your starting point. After the rough cast is done, we switch to a flat bottom point cutter for finishing. Here, the automatic tool setter is super important. Every time you change the bit, the machine needs to redetect the length, right? There's a button at the bottom right, press it, and the head moves to the top left corner to automatically set the tool offset. Then it resumes the next step automatically. Finally, we switch back to the single edge spiral end mill again to cut the piece out. After finishing, use a bunch of wood chips, just vacuum them up. For this wolf head carving, there were some small burrs. Simply brush them off and apply a bit of oil. For larger burrs, use sandpaper for smoothing. And here you go, the final result. Looks stunning, right? The details are rich, the relief is vivid, the hair, the eyes, it feels like it's crafted by master. And that's the basic workflow. Of course, to get the best results, you may need to tweak a few parameters. For example, adjusting the line spacing in the software for more refined detail. But overall, it's not that hard. A few tries and you get the hang of it. And that's for wood, but what about metal? Well, I used to create a 4mm 60-61 aluminum fidget spinner, and it came out smooth and precise. The accuracy is impressive, and I will test that specifically later, so stay tuned. I also tried engraving a snow mountain design on polyurethane, which came out beautifully detailed at 80x80mm. The device supports materials up to 280x280mm, which is huge for a desktop machine. Lastly, I engraved my name, Samuel Tech, 2mm deep on beech wood. Check how clean it looks! No burns, no smoke, and super fast compared to laser engraving. And that's one of the advantages of the CNC machine. But there is even more that makes the MaxMaker device stand out. Let me walk you through every single feature. First up, the flywheel clamping module. This is a must-have for securing small parts, like brass pieces. We mount it on the work table and use a flat bottom point cutter with a black coating, designed specifically for metal machining. The clamp can hold materials of various sizes, super handy and versatile. Next, let's move on to the semi-clamp module. I also use this part to test the machine's precision, dust collection, and noise. It features a magnetic dust hood that's easy to attach and remove. You can connect the included adapter tube at the back and plug in your vacuum cleaner, if it's most models. Without a vacuum and with the cover open, the noise measured around 70 decibels. Close the shield, it drops to 65 decibels. Pretty acceptable. With the vacuum on, the brake gets sucked effectively. We machine an 80x80x80mm chemical wood step block. And the error readings were 0.01mm, 0.07mm, and 0mm. Our standing accuracy, almost exactly as advertised, especially considering this is just a prototype I'm testing. Next up, the vacuum section platform. We use it to engrave a metal plate, attach it with 4 screws, seal it with silicon strips, and the plate stays firm in place even when pushed from all sides. Compared to clamps, it's easier to remove, powerful batch processing, and safer for solder machining. We use a 60mm bit and swap the collet using a 17mm wrench. During processing, the noise level was around 72 to 75 decibels. Pretty reasonable, since metal is much harder than wood or plastic. As for accuracy, the results came out at 60.01x60.03x60.01mm, which is incredibly precise. Our design joint was exactly 60x60x60mm. The machining result looks excellent, with a very smooth surface finish. Now, let's check out the fourth axis module. It allows for rotary carving. After rough and fine processing, our final product was a chess bishop. Look at how smooth and curves are, absolutely beautiful. As I mentioned earlier, it also includes a 10W laser head. Installation is simple, slide it into the slot, plug in the connector, and you're ready. Switch from CNC mode to laser mode in the software, and engrave the Samuel Tech. The result? Super crisp edges, smooth lines, no jagged borders. Last but not least, the 3D probe. It helps automatically set the X, Y, and Z coordinates. Install it just like a 2-bit. Plug it in, when connected, it turns green. When triggered, it turns red. It accurately detects the workpiece surface and quickly registers your starting point, making setup way easier and faster. And that's the Hamea DYSNC from MaxMake. A seriously powerful, precise, and versatile desktop machine that takes DIY creativity to the next level. From wood to metal, from 2D engraving to 4-axis machining, this thing can redo it all. I just love the way it handles metal. It's outstanding, and something a normal desktop laser engraver could never achieve. Of course, it's not perfect, the silverware still needs some polish. But once that's refined, this could easily become one of the best all-in-one desktop CNC and laser combo machines out there. If you're into metalwork, wood carving, or just love making cool stuff, this might be the one for you. Right now, it's live on Kickstarter at the fast early bird price, but it only has a little over 10 days left. So if you are interested, make sure you don't miss this trend. Thanks for watching. I'm Sammy, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.